for his statement. I now have the honor to give the floor to Her Excellency Retno LP Masood, Minister of Foreign Affairs of Indonesia, to make a statement.
Mr. President, Excellencies, global nuclear disarmament remains elusive and suffers from frequent setbacks. More than 13,000 nuclear weapons remain in existence. The threat of nuclear war is ever present, with escalating tension between nuclear weapons countries. We cannot be truly safe from the threat of nuclear weapons until we completely eliminate them. Today, I would like to make 2 points. First, preserve the sanctity of the NPT. Let us reaffirm our commitment to the 3 pillars of the NPT, especially the slow-moving disarmament pillar. Nuclear arms race and power projection must be avoided, since they will erode the integrity and credibility of the NPT. We must seize the momentum toward the 10th NPT Review Conference to encourage frank dialogue and trust building between nuclear weapons countries and map out next practical step in nuclear disarmament. Humanitarian consequences of nuclear weapons, their possible use by non-state state actors and human error should be our common ground to accelerate nuclear disarmament. Second, strengthen the nuclear disarmament architecture. The Treaty for the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons entry into force this year is a very important milestone, providing legal framework to delegitimize nuclear weapons and raise moral barriers against their threat. The treaty complements and mutually reinforces the NPT rather than undermining it. I call on countries that have not signed the treaty to do so and be part of the positive force toward global nuclear disarmament. We also look forward to seeing entry into force of comprehensive test ban treaty and accession of nuclear weapon countries to nuclear weapons free zone treaties. Colleagues, excellencies, total elimination of nuclear weapons is the only way to safeguard humanity. Nuclear war will never be won. Thus, we must work to prevent it from ever being fought. I thank you very much.
I thank the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Indonesia for her statement.